For anyone who isn't a chemist, you've probably always ignored that weird chunk of the periodic table that floats below the main elements that we have to memorize in school. You know, this chunk, right here. And that's probably because we don't know a lot about these elements. These are the lanthanoids and actinoids, and new research is only just starting to shed light on how these bizarre heavy elements really behave, and how little we know about their chemistry. All the elements in the periodic table are organized by increasing atomic number, a number that usually corresponds to atomic mass. Beyond mass, elements are also grouped by kind and similar properties. Lanthanoids and actinoids are two distinct groups that are often taken together because they're both part of the inner transition series that sits within transition metals. The elements in these two groups are also structured differently than other elements at the atomic level. Looking specifically at actinoids, they're typically soft, silvery metals that are both dense and yet malleable. You could cut some of them with a knife. Thorium is like soft steel. When it's heated, you can roll it into a sheet or pull it into wire. Actinoids are also lightly paramagnetic, pyrophoric, which means they spontaneously ignite when exposed to air, and with the exception of actinium, they have multiple crystalline phases. But their most notable defining characteristic is that they are all radioactive. And it gets stranger. Only 4 known actinoids occur naturally on planet Earth. The others are created in a lab. But no matter where they come from, actinoids are the heaviest and least understood elements that we know. Among these synthetic elements is berkelium, and it's defying quantum mechanics. Berkelium was discovered by scientists at, you guessed it, Berkeley, in 1949. It's an actinoid, so we know it's radioactive, but that's almost everything we know about it. The element is so difficult and expensive to make that there is almost none in existence. There's less than a gram in the whole world. And there's only one isotope that chemists can work with, 249BK, and it decays quickly. It has a half-life of only 320 days. But, you know, less than a gram is still some. The Department of Energy recently gave scientists 13 milligrams to work with. Unlike the lighter elements at the top of the periodic table, quantum mechanics can't really explain what's going on with the electrons at the heart of this element. But scientists think it might have something to do with Einstein's theory of relativity. The electrons in berkelium seem to follow his prediction that says as objects move faster, they get heavier. The electrons move around the element's charged nucleus at a significant fraction of the speed of light. And this is what's making the element heavy and behave in ways that can't be explained by quantum theory, which is leading researchers to wonder how they can either make the reaction stronger or shut it down altogether. Until now, berkelium has mainly been used to make new elements like tennessine. So this is one of the first dedicated experiments scientists have done to learn about the element itself. And really, it's teaching us that the element is hard to understand. Berkelium is making theories about chemistry bend and break, but it's all in the name of understanding the full table of our elements and the chemistry that comes with them. Photo galleries, blogs, e-commerce, those are also elements, but instead of for nature, they're for your very own website. Domain.com is awesome, affordable, reliable, and has all the tools you need to build a new website. They can fulfill all your website needs. They offer .com and .net domain names and intuitive website builders. They have over 300 domain extensions to fit your needs, from .club to .space to .ninja to .pizza. Take that first step in creating an identity online and visit domain.com. You want to know more about the crazy states of matter? We dug so deep into it that my brain hurt over on Seeker Plus. Check it out here. One last thing, our periodic table was created by Dmitry Mendeleev. He wrote the elements on cards and he practiced rearranging them until it hit him to put them in the order of relative atomic mass. That was in 1869 when there were only 63 known. Thanks for watching.